through responsive and efficient service for the benefit of the Filipino people. So this resolution is filed and will be adopted this afternoon in plenary session.
Okay, first question from Big Semintak of Net 25.
Magandang hapon po, Big Semintak of Net 25. Can I ask a question about PI, aside from the House resolution? So, ano po ang reaction ng leadership ng House of Representatives now that the COMELEC, nag-decide sila kanina, nag-press con si Chairman George Garcia, na indefinitely ay pinopospon po nila lahat ng procedure sa pagtanggap ng perma regarding the People's Initiative?
Well, we welcome that move from the Commission on Election. Anyway, if there is a need for them to review any of the rules, we welcome that. But while the COMELEC reviews it, there are other very important House or legislative matters that we are also pushing for. So, wala pong problema. We welcome the act of the COMELEC.
Okay. My second question, second and last question with regards to the House resolution. May we know kung yan ba ay ginawa ng House leadership yung expression of full support to PBBM matapos yung nangyaring pag-atake ni former President PRRD sa Presidente?
Thank you very much. Actually, nung nilabas po ng House leadership yung manifesto support, it's a reiteration of a position we have already stated last year. And after the launch of Bagong Pilipinas, kung saan mahigit sa 100 kongresista ang dumalo, naniwala po kami sa nilalayo ng Bagong Pilipinas, sa maadhikain at pagbabago na gustong ipatupad ng ating Pangulo. So wala po itong kinalaman sa mga nangyari sa rally sa Davao. This is just to show the firm commitment of the House of Representatives to the leadership and the administration of President Ferdinand Bongbong Marcos.
Thank you po.
Anyone? Billy Vega sa Politico and Abante.
Magandang hapon po. Sir, tatanong ko lang po, ano po ba yung stand ng majority do sa People's Initiative?
We as far as the House of Representatives is concerned, it is not secret that the House of Representatives ever since had been advocating that there is a need to update that 37-year-old constitution. Hindi po first time na pinag-uusapan yan. Even in previous congresses, 18th Congress, 17th Congress, even in the past, there had always been that move to update that constitution. So everyone is in agreement na kailangan talaga i-update. Now, in the 19th Congress, we had been advocating for that. In fact, we filed RBH6. Kung ang Senado may RBH6, kami may RBH6 rin. We filed the RBH6 last year, March of last year, wherein 302 members of the House are authors. 302 po. With 302 votes, 302 congressmen passed that RBH6. At it has been transmitted to the Senate. Ang tanong nga namin eh, nasaan na ba? Nag-hearing na ba yung Senate tungkol sa RBH6, which seeks to update the economic provisions of the Constitution through Constitutional Convention. Concon po yun. So, if you ask now, what is our stand regarding People's Initiative? Well, we'll support it. Kasi hindi naman po sikreto na gusto talaga namin amendahan ang Constitution, even the Senate filed their RBH6, authored by the Senate President and two other senators. So we are all in agreement. Lahat po kami, sangayon. We are all in agreement that we have to update that 37-year-old Constitution. So if he asks us now, are we supportive of the People's Initiative? Why not? We have proposed to amend it, CONCON, last year, March last year. I repeat, 302 congressmen authored it, passed it, RBH6. We transmitted RBH6 to the Senate. Ano po yung mod nun? Constitutional Convention, CONCON. In the same manner, the Senate also filed their RBH6, yung sa kanila CONAS, Constituent Assembly. Also, to amend the economic provision. So we're not, I think there is no argument now that from the Senate to the House, we all, I think, have the same mind and same track of school of thought that we have to amend the economic provisions of that update, that 37-year-old Constitution.
With the permission of the Majority Leader, maybe it's best also that we hear from the Chairman of the Committee on Constitutional Amendments.
Yes. July, we approved resolution to both Houses number 6, as stated already, 302 signatures and votes against 7 against the measure calling for a constitutional convention to tackle economic provisions. In spite of that, then it was sent to the Senate. Senator Padilla, the chairman of the Constitutional Committee and Revision of Laws in the Senate, held one hearing. First, they invited me, and then the next day, before the hearing, I was disinvited regarding resolution both houses, meaning they do not want to really act on what overwhelmingly was approved by the House of Representatives. And so what happened here is that, you know, there are many sectors who want to have this change. We have business group, Foundation for Economic Freedom, even the PCCI, even the MAP in our hearing said that it's really a felt need of our country, because according to these organizations, in the ASEAN country, FDIs, foreign direct investments, the Philippines is now number 8 among 10 members. Vietnam, 6 years ago, has overtaken the Philippines in FDIs. 2 years ago, Cambodia has overtaken us. We are only ahead, according to these business organizations, we are ahead of Laos and Myanmar. So they were very much in favor. The same is true with two big organizations. PIRMA, People's Initiative for Reform, Modernization, and Action, which has been doing this advocacy to change for the past 10 years. And the CORE movement, which has been doing this for the past 7 years, especially during the Duterte administration. They have wanted to already have charter change. So when it came out that there is no action of the Senate that about our overwhelming resolution to call for a constitutional convention for changes in the economic provisions. Well, I am chairman, and they have been with me for some time. They came to us and said, paano naman ito, chair? What we have been discussing, what we have been hearing, nothing is happening in the Senate. So we intend, according to these organizations, we intend to already go to People's Initiative. And I said, I am for change. They do not want to act on our House resolution. Then we're going, I personally will support you, and I'd like you to see the leadership. That is where these organizations got the support of Congress, because it has been our advocacy since the 8th Congress. Let me now run through you. No? 36 years already of constitutional change bills and resolutions. How many were filed since 1988-89, after the 87 Constitution? A total of 358 charter change measures have been filed with the House from the 8th Congress to the present 19th Congress. When I, to make it short, because mahaba itong ano, it is my record in the committee as chairman. Let me just go to the 14th Congress where I was elected for the first time, 2007. What did the 14th Congress do? Because our records in the committee shows all the measures filed from the 8th Congress. In the 14th Congress, I was a neophyte congressman. Ito ha, 2007. What was approved by the House? The House approved, okay, 14th Congress. It passed House Resolution Number 1109. What does it say? Calling on Congress to convene for the purpose of considering proposals to amend or revise the Constitution by a vote of 3/4 of all its members. Okay, the same is true in the 15th, 16th, and then here in the 16th Congress, I was with Speaker Belmonte. The Speaker really wanted this to be approved and was the main proponent of this. 16th Congress, this is now my third term. The House adopted resolution of both houses, RBH number 1, duly approved overwhelmingly, proposing amendments to certain economic provisions of the Constitution, particularly Article 12 on the economy, 14 and 16. This is on public utilities, developed natural resources, education, media, and advertising. These are, and then this was transmitted to the Senate. Nothing happened in the 14th Congress, and nothing happened in the 16th Congress. Now here, I'm back as committee chairman. Said we are now on the 19th Congress. That is where we approved last July, 302 votes to the Senate, and there was one hearing. I was disinvited, and then nothing is heard of it, of the measure. And so that is the situation. We are supporting the initiatives of these organizations to secure the signatures, and we have done that. And we have more than 12% already, and we are ready to file the petition. However, Senate President Subiri with Senator Sonny Angara and Loren Regarda, they filed RBH 6. And so the Speaker immediately, in his speech here in Congress, in the opening last January 22nd, he stated that he is supporting this particular measure by the Senate leadership. For the first time, there has been a bill filed on these economic provisions in the Senate. And then, in a letter that he sent to the Senate President, we support and let us therefore continue to proceed with economic amendments, very, very clear. Only economic amendments. They're saying that you are here, that the PI is out to abolish the Senate. Farthest from the truth. We have no plans of abolishing the Senate. We need a Senate. We need this body to be able to have check and balance, for example. But they are putting provisions not in what you have approved. Remember, RBH 6 approved last July. There is nothing about political amendments, only economic amendments. So there is nothing that can be changed there. There can be no political, because the next action is theirs. So there is therefore only economic. So they are afraid of something, they're afraid of their own shadows. So the reason why there's People's Initiative is because the Senate has refused to act on 400, measures already that was filed here, including the last one, RBH 6, last July. And so that is the situation now. That is a present situation. They approved this before the Holy Week. They approved the three, and we plan to stop the People's Initiative. To allay fears. Ang gusto lang naman namin dito is to be able to have this economic amendment so that we can have the FDIs coming, more job opportunities, more corporate taxes for social programs, and more development in education and other development of our resources. So that is the present situation. We'd like to assure the Senate, nothing is about political amendments in this PI. It will only be economic amendments. Thank you.
Mayor Lalis Moras from Channel 4.
Hi, good afternoon po. I know may statement na po dito si House Majority Leader Dalipe, pero may I just ask for the record, ano po yung masasabi natin sa hearing tomorrow ng Senate? Baka may i-add din po yung ating ibang House leaders. And may I just ask your statement, Majo Dalipe, for the record, for the sake of TV soundbite lang po. Thank you.
Yes, we already issued that statement. Wala naman pong problema. Actually, meron din kaming mga iba ring mga ginagawa, but in any case, whatever. We always welcome, but as what we have stated, if we in the House of Representatives is welcoming their RBH6, 'di ba? Sila yung nag-file. Economic provision, nag-file yang ang Senado. Sabi ni Speaker Martin Romualdez, sinabi ng mga congressman, we welcome, i-adapt po natin yung anong gusto nyo. Okay kami, walang problema. In fact, gusto rin nga namin, pwede ba? Tingnan nyo rin yung gusto tinransmit namin sa inyo nung last year pa sa Senado, yung RBH6 ng House, which is CONCON. So, actually, kuan na nga, lahat ng mode na. Siguro, isang result na rin yung PI na yung mga grupo na pagod na sa kakahintay, di ba? May nag-file ng CONCON. Anong nangyari? Hinihintay pa rin natin hanggang ngayon. Wala pa rin. Nag-file yung Senate ng CONAS. Wala pa rin nangyari. In fact, backtrack ko pa. 2021, last Congress, nag-file ang House. CONAS rin. Ang nakalagay doon na, dekahon na yun. Kung anong gusto ng Senado, binibigay na natin voting separately. Last Congress. You check RBH number 2, the House of Representatives passed that with 270 plus votes. Ano nakalagay doon sa RBH 2? Amend the economic provisions, voting separately pa po yun. Nandun na sa Senado. Anong nangyari? Ewan ko na. 19 Congress na tayo ngayon. Pareho na kami. CONCON gusto namin, gusto nila CONAS. Siguro, sabi ni Chairman Rufus Rodriguez, may mga grupo dyan. Nagpapirma na lang kasi baka wala pa rin mangyayari na lahat tayo in agreement, whether the Senate and the House, there is really a need to update the 37-year-old Constitution. Kailangan po, kailangan na natin i-update yon. Kung hindi mahuhuli ang Pilipinas.
I think in addition with the RBH6, some senator, our friends in the Senate, nasabi din na they will tackle RBH6 if they will stop the PI. Actually, hindi po kami ang nagpapastop ng PI. And now, there is a development that the COMELEC suspends accepting the signature. So wala na po sigurong masasabi. Sabi ni Speaker Martin, we will embrace resolution both houses number 6. We will adopt in the House of Representatives. So kami po, palagay namin, ihihir na nila yan, idiretso na nila yung RBH6 para po patapos na. And our speaker wrote a letter to SP Meigs para dun sa RBH6. So wala po akong nakikita bakit hindi po nila ituloy yung hearing sa RBH6. Salamat po.
Kat Forbes, Jenny Escapante of GMA Online.
Good afternoon po, sirs and ma'ams. I would like to ask lang po for a comment dun sa sinabi ni former President Duterte that amendments to change the Constitution is also a way of perpetuating the current president in power. So how do you respond po? As we are all well aware, some of you are, you know, used to be allies of the former president. So how do you comment on that? How do you respond?
Klarong-klaro po sa pinail namin, economic provision. Kasi you cannot do something na hindi parte dun eh. We filed it eh. I think they have to read first what we have filed instead of trying to speculate or trying to, you know, think of something that is not there. Klaro po. We transmitted it to the Senate. We asked everyone. We asked everybody who has a different thought of this. Can they read what we have filed? Wala pong nagsasabi na political dun. Economic. Ever since last Congress, economic. So, we even do not know if this is just a strategy to stonewall again a very important need to update an constitution, an old constitution. Eh, kasi ganun nangyari, yun ang feeling nga ng lahat. May magso-stonewall na naman, haharangin na naman, eh lahat tayo, alam naman na lahat, kailangan na natin i-update yung constitution natin. At in each and every initiation of that act of amending the constitution, ang feeling ng lahat, namamatay po sa Senado. Eh bakit, nag-file na nga kami last year, last Congress eh, voting separately na ngayon eh. Ngayon, siguro sabi ng mga people's organization, i-voting jointly na lang natin. O saan na ba tayo pupunta? Diba? Kami yung nag-file ha. If you read again, economic. It's not a secret. All the records are you can review all the records. It's always economic. We haven't filed and transmitted to the Senate anything about political. And you can check the records of the Senate, what we have transmitted to them. It's economic. So yung mga nagsasabi na to perpetuate the president or whoever in power, maybe they're in a different dimension at the time na, baka nga, fentanyl.
Thank you, sir.
In addition to what the majority leader has mentioned, no, let's rewind administrations a bit. Let's not forget that in the previous administrations, there were two concrete attempts to amend the Constitution. One was to convert the Philippine political system into a federal form of government. And another one, when the latter part was a move done by Congress, again, addressed to the Senate. Ito pong ginagawa natin ngayon sa 19th Congress, kami na nga po ang nagsasabi na economic provisions lang ang pag-usapan natin. Wala po kami pinag-uusapan political dito. Kung merong usapin political na babaguhin, nangyari po yun noong nakaraang administrasyon. Dahil noong nakaraan, gustong nga gawin nila, i-federal form of system ang ating bansa. Dito, we've been consistent since last year with the resolutions that we transmitted to the Senate, economic provisions. We reiterated this position again, economic provisions. Now, I think it's time for the Senate to act and to work on the economic provisions. Dahil sa totoo lang, wala na po talaga kaming nakikita ang dahilan. At ayaw naman natin sabihin na sila nagiging hadlang sa kaunlaran at pagbabago na ninanais ng ating administrasyon.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you po.
Next question from Kat Forbes of Radyo Pilipinas.
Sirs, medyo paling lang po ako ng kaunti, no? Pero related pa rin po sa Chacha. Meron pa po tayong tatlo na pending LEDAC and SONA bills po, no? Kung sakali pong maipasa ng Senado yung RBH6, kakayanin din po ba ng Kamara na tapusin po yun within, bago po mag session break po by March?
Alin po yung tatapusin?
Yung sa LEDAC and SONA bills po, kakayanin po bang maisabay tapusin kasama po yung RBH6 kung sakali pong aksyonan na po ng Senate?
Dito po ha, dito, you know, ako as majority leader, I am really thankful to to all the House leaders, nandito po yung mga political leaders of all political parties. The House of Representatives is 6 months advance in passing all the LEDAC, even SONA priority measures. At tapos na po kami. Pati po yung mga sinuggest na ipasok sa LEDAC para maging priority na suggestion po ng Senate, pinasa po namin. We are always supportive. The House of Representatives is always supportive for any legislative measure which will help our country. Maski yung suggestion ng Senate, pinasa na namin lahat. Wala kaming tinutulugan na batas dito. We have passed. So, in front of you, I'm telling you, without these political party leaders, the support of the different political parties here in the House of Representatives, we would not be accomplishing all these legislative measures 6 months in advance. So kung ang tanong, kaya ba namin tapusin pa kung anong dadagdag ng Senate sa LEDAC? Kaya. You know, we are one united. We are all in agreement that we have to support the legislative priority measures that President Bongbong Marcos wants us to pass to help this country. So the House of Representatives is not remiss. Again, we are 6 months in advance of the deadline. So napasa po namin yan. Kung meron pa idadagdag, wala po. Masisipag po yung mga congressman. Every day, makikita nyo po yung mga committee chairman namin nagtatrabaho. So wala po. Anything, we welcome. If there are any additional legislative priorities that the president, the senators, whoever wants that we include in the LEDAC, na kailangan ipasa, tatrabahuin po namin. And we'll make sure that in the 19th Congress, it gets passed.
Gusto ko lang ulitin yung sinabi ni Speaker. Wala po tayong back subject dito sa House of Representatives. Humingi po silang additional 6 months extension. So, nagkikiusap po kami sa mga kasama namin sa Senado kung pwede magtrabaho na po tayo. Ano? Yan po, na nasuspend na po yung pag-accept ng mga signatures. I think we can tackle all the pending priority measures, the SONA and the LEDAC measures of the President. Yun lang po.
Next question from ABS-CBN's RG Cruz.
Good afternoon po, sir. To Majo or anybody from the House leaders, how would you, what path forward do you see? Kasi halata po na may trust issues ang Senate sa House. So how do you think can those trust issues be overcome?
Yes, sir. Majo. Yes, I'm Jack Duavin from the Nationalist People's Coalition. Basically, you know, we'd just like to say this. Sa lahat po ng partido sa Pilipinas, ang NPC po ang may pinakamaraming senador. Meron po kaming 5 senador. And there is nothing and nobody that can make us vote on any measure to abolish them and the other senators. Kung titingnan natin ang numero kung anong nasa konstitusyon, tignan nyo na lang po yung porsyento namin. Konti na lang, hindi na sila ma-abolish sigurado. At hindi lang naman kami ang may senador na kasama. So sana yung issue na po na yan, na ma-abolish sila or whatever, isang tabi na. I really don't think it's possible at all.
And to add, hindi NPC ilan sila? 6 na 5 senators. Ba't nila abolish kami sa lakas? Ang party chairman ng lakas is a senator. Ba't namin na-abolish yung party chairman namin sa lakas, which is Senator Bong Revilla? So I think yung mga nag-iisip na kung ano-ano, let's focus. Ngayon, yung trust issues, open na. Sinabi ni Speaker, we'll adopt your version. Kung ano yung gusto ng Senate, adopt namin. Kung anong economic provision, di ba? Yun naman eh. When we resume, the Speaker made the in his speech, in the resumption of the session, we are supportive of RBH6 of the Senate. Dapat nga, kung ako nga sasabihin, Speaker, dapat sabihan rin natin yung Senate, meron rin tayo sa atin eh, con-con yun eh. Bakit hindi rin nila simulan yung debates and discussion dun sa Senate regarding our RBH6, which is CONCON, Constitutional Convention. Pero, Sa sobrang bait ni Speaker, gusto niya matapos na. Basta, kasi kailangan talaga eh. Umiikot sila sa buong mundo. Kailangan, we really have to update our constitution. We have to open up our economy. Anong sabi ni Speaker Martin Romualdez? Sige, adapt na lang natin kung anong gusto ng Senate. Ngayon, may usapan pa dahil sa PA. Come on, let's not give any reason. Focus tayo. Anong kailangan gawin? Kailangan natin amendahan. We have to update the Constitution.
And, the question really was, how do we move forward? Right? With the trust issue. The trust issue is precisely because it started also with the people's organizations like PIRMA and CORE movement having no more trust in the Senate that they will act on what was approved in the House. And therefore, coming in, we have trust, of course, issues with them. However, the Speaker, we met yesterday after the Bangon Pilipinas kickoff rally attended by 400,000 people. Nag-usap kami. And of course, the Speaker said that he has been in touch with the SP, Subiri, to meet with them, their leadership and the leadership of the House. Ready, mag-host the Speaker for dinner. And if they will meet, then that will be the way to move forward. They can discuss what to do. They have resolution, both houses, number six, three mandatory provisions for three provisions. We have six. And then they can decide. Because if they are going to really, if the Senate is really, you know, sincere in having the economic provisions, matatapos na yan. So therefore, Speaker Romualdez is again urging the Senate to meet with him and discuss these things. There will be no more constitutional crisis if we have dinners with this our leadership. Because ang lang naman is economic. And now the COMELEC already will not accept. So hold na talaga. So what is now there is that there are the two resolutions of both houses. Let us refine them. Let them meet and let them decide. The people cannot wait. Let us have the economic provisions amendments very much sooner. Thank you.
Yeah, just to comment on that whole trust issue, Arjuno, I think it goes both ways. You know, if the Senate thinks that they cannot trust us, you know, we can also push forth the same argument to them. Where's RBH6 that we passed last year? How come walang activity doon? But hindi nyo, but hindi kayo nag-act? Wala man lang discussion, wala man lang debates nangyari doon, di ba? Kami nag-aantay. At wag nyo naman isasantabi yung paglagda ng mahigit 300 kongresista. I mean, these are not just co-authors. These are authors of that bill. And we wanted to push forward. How come the Senate did not act? And now, here's another opportunity for us to amend the Constitution, and now they're pushing another reason why they won't act. So I guess it's really finding out from them whether or not are you with us in securing charter amendments for a better Philippines. So I think that's the better question that the Senate should ask. And ako naman, personally, you know, we want to move forward. We want to work with them. We want to make sure that there's collaboration between both houses so that no gridlock and deadlocks occur, especially undergoing the legislative process on numerous bills and resolutions that we file.
From DCWB, Isa Bendanya.
Magandang hapon po kay House Majority Leader Dalipi po or anyone po. Kamusta po yung moral ngayon ng House of Representatives? Kasi simula po nung nag-start yung People's Initiative, kayo na po yung napaparatangan, kayo na po yung sinisisi, kayo po yung binabanggit na nasa likod nitong PI. So kamusta po kayo and kamustahin ko na rin po yung buo pa po ba yung suporta nyo talaga kay House Speaker Romualdez? Hindi ba natitibag? Or well, hindi ba siya affected nitong mga nangyayari po? Thank you.
Lalong lumalakas ang House of Representatives. Kaya nga, sabi ko kanina, kung meron pang additional legislative priorities, the House is strong and united to pass all these measures. So, walang pong problema. And regarding yung mga paratang na na tungkol sa PI, di ba I said, we are supportive. Kasi these are organizations who might be already fed up and tired of waiting na walang nangyayari sa House of Representatives and Senate regarding the amendments on the of the Constitution. So, hindi naman po sikreto na we have always been advocating for that. Even the Senate, they even filed a few days ago, RBHX. Ibig sabihin, lahat sumusuporta sa amendment, sa updating of the Constitution. Ngayon, kung may grupo na nagsimula ng papirma, ipokrito naman kami, sasabihin namin, ay wag natin suportahan. Eh, baka sabihin mo, Congressman, baka yan na yung sagot. Baka dyan, yan na yung paraan. Kasi parati tayong walang nangyayari eh. Sa CONAS, CONCON, voting jointly, voting ano ba, separately. Sabi ko nga, last Congress, sinabi nga namin, ano yung CONAS na proposal namin? Economic provision, voting separately pa yun. Walang nangyari. So ngayon, may grupo, gusto nila magpapirma, siguro sila rin, pagod na. Walang nangyayari sa Senate and sa House. So may isa pang mode, and that is in the Constitution. Nandun po yun. Ang sa amin lang nga is CONAS and CONCON. Constitutional Assembly, Constitutional Convention. Eh may mga ibang grupo na nakita nila, o meron pa pala isa. Ano yun? People's Initiative. Baka may mangyari na dito. At least, sa People's Initiative, wala na dyan yung Senado. Wala na dyan yung Congressman. Kasi ilang administrasyon na, paulit-ulit lang eh. Walang nangyayari. So, People's Initiative na. Ngayon ang tanong, gusto ba namin supportan? Why not? Because we have been advocating for it ever since. Hindi pa ako congressman. Itong mga ibang kasama ko dito, congressman na sila, kinekwento nila sa akin, dati pa yan. Whether President Ramos, President Gloria Macapagal, President Duterte, o mas iba pa ngayon kay President Duterte. Federal government, mas iba pa yung ina-advocate nila. Eh sa amin, economic provisions lang po. So, do we support the PI? Why not? It might be the solution. Can we also?
Yeah. With regards to the second part of your question, yung moral, I think it's best that the individual party leaders would speak on behalf of their party and their support for Speaker Martin Romualdez.
Well, as far as moral, I think it's just the same. No, I mean, pareho rin naman eh. I mean, we, well, kami po sa NPC, we think of ourselves as like the worker ants, no? In every Congress. And you know, while we may not agree on everything, at least what we can say, as far as Congress and our parties, we've been consistent. And none of this is new. Maybe it's I sound blasé, pero we've seen this, we've gone through this so many times. It's not something that would really like affect us and keep us from doing our work well. Like what was mentioned is, and I told this to members of the press in the last Congress when there were questions about the CONAS drive naman of the former speaker, that there are built-in safeguards. So we just really are trying to work within the process, as the process allows. And whatever comes our way, we're just going to just work through it. So I guess moral is just same.
NP.
Yes, good afternoon. As far as the Nacionalista Party is concerned, we would want to confirm that we are fully supportive of our speaker. For one thing, we feel in him the same desire that we district representatives want for our constituents. He has been helping us, especially in my case where my province needs more assistance. And the more important thing is our speaker is really a total doer, and he supports everybody. So the NP fully supports our speaker.
I think it goes the same with all the other party leaders. As for the PCFI, we have been very supportive of the speaker. In fact, we are even more united now more than ever, and that goes to show that our leader in the House of Representatives is a working leader and is someone who we can trust, and ganun din yung binibigay niya sa amin, no? The relationship is very good.
If I may add to the position of the party list group, no, they always say trust is earned, and I think in almost 2 years that the speaker has been leading the house, that trust has been well earned. As party leaders, we have the unique opportunity of meeting the speaker almost every week to discuss matters of the house, and no party leader can actually refute the fact that the speaker is the most hard-working congressman right now in Congress. And that gives us more reason to work even harder and trust him even more. Thank you.
Good afternoon. I'm not a party leader, pero I'm a member of the... I'm the Deputy Majority Leader for Communications. So I have the privilege to attend in every meeting of the party leaders. Sa totoo lang ho, pag may mga issues, may mga problema, pinapatawag po ni Speaker lahat po ng party leaders to make one decision. Pag nagkakaroon po ng discussions, so unanimous po yung decision lagi, or dapat 100%. Kasi pag may kumontra, may affected, tinatanong. Kaya minsan no, inaabot po ng hours and hours ang meeting po ng mga party leaders. And the speaker would only adopt yung decision ng mga party leaders. Hindi lang naman ho siya ang nagde-decide hunong, kundi he always consults with the party leaders. Ganun ho yung mga meeting with the party leaders. So pag ibig sabihin, pag naaprubahan ho, nag-usap-usap yung party leaders, aprobado po sa lahat po ng party leaders, then ina-adapt po ng speaker yon, then we bring it to the floor. Ganun lang po yun. So, supportado po, at yung decision ng speaker galing din po sa decision ng party leaders.
Okay. The question earlier about the trust, in trust issues. Honestly, we don't know where it was coming from. Kasi we were pushing only for economic reforms. And in fact, it is stated clearly dun sa RBH2 and RBH6 that the lower house has passed, no, for the last two congresses, and even last year. No. So the issue that there is a hidden agenda na meron nagsasabi no election scenario, may nagsasabi na extension of term limits, saan ho nakalagay yun? Di ba? I mean, you know, these people selling this idea are out there to stop the effort to amend the Constitution. And I hope it's not coming from our friends from the Senate, because I am sure that they also want to amend the economic provisions of the Constitution. So, dapat tingnan natin yun doon. Ngayon, nanggaling na mismo sa leadership at dun sa ating leader sa mababang kapulungan na nagsasabi na ipasa niyo yung RBH6 dyan sa Senado at i-adapt natin yan. We will embrace it, as the speaker would want to say it. We will embrace whatever you pass there. So, whatever they pass there, if it's just economic amendments, therefore, what we will embrace and adapt are also economic amendments. So, wala hong pinag-uusapan na political dito. So, disabuse your minds and your imagination from these political provisions that you are selling to the people. If you're just out there to stop this effort to amend the Constitution, you're not doing any good to this country. This country needs the immediate economic reforms because we're left behind. Naiwanan na ho tayo ng ating mga kapitbansa sa Asia. So, magtulungan ho tayo dito. The Senate and the House must sit down, discuss. We can even debate and argue. But at the end of the day, we must all agree to disagree. So, panawagan po namin yan sa ating mga kaibigan sa Senado.
Secretary General, DS, Mian.
Yes, as a member representing the National People's Coalition, I just need to say four things. One is our support with the Bagong Pilipinas initiative, and to our President Bongbong Marcos that we're still here supporting his leadership. And second, of course, our House Speaker Martin Robledas, we still support his leadership. He is our House Leader. He's been leading us, doing all this work that the legislative group has been passing. We passed all the LEDAC bills 6 months ago. Natapos na namin all the LEDAC bills, unless there are new priority bills that will be introduced. Third, me for myself, I really support the economic provisions that needs to be updated to our Constitution. Matagal na nung 18th Congress, I was there. We passed the economic provisions amendments to the Constitution, pero hindi yata gumalaw sa Senate. And last year, as mentioned, yung CONCON naman yung pre-propose namin, and still it's not moving. But then, yung fourth naman, being an NPC member, and we do have 5 NPC Senate members, parang I would just like to add na sila po kaibigan namin, all the senators, not just NPC members, but all the senators. We've been working with them. They've helped us pass our local bills. We work together with them for other national bills. And maganda po yung working relationship namin. And I still believe na ganun pa rin until now. And of course, to add, yung pabalik dun sa why we want econ provision, kasi like in sa yung bagong Pilipinas movement natin, we said that we want to bring the government programs to every Filipino, and it's only through these economic provisions na nakikita ko na magagawa natin to. Because when we start bringing in foreign investment na mas malaki pa than what we are getting now, dahil sila magiging confident na sila to invest in our country, lahat yan domino effect na. And then at the end, the government will be collecting more. And kung yung mga constituents natin, they complain that the basic social services kulang ang tupad na nakakarating sa kanila. Yung AICS na ibibigay, kulang din daw. Sa yung mga tulong na pwedeng ibigay sa mga hospitals for those who can't afford hospitalization, kulang din daw. But when all these things happen in the near future, kung na-amend na nga natin yung ating constitution, the economic provisions are in place, lalaki na rin tong pondo kasi na mapupunta sa gobyerno natin, and we'll have plenty to share to our people. Mas magaganda na yung may bibigay natin na social services sa ating mga kababayan. And that's it. Thank you.
Kojoloy?
Yes. Good afternoon po sa lahat. Dalawang bagay lang po, no, para sa akin. Very important sa atin mga Pilipino ang pagkakataon na pumili ng leader sa bawat lugar, like President, Vice President, Senators, Congressman, Mayors, Governors. Importante po. No, ako po ay taga Mindanao. Now, ilang administrasyon na rin ang inabot ko mula pa nung panahon pa ni Kung Datong Makapagal. Every administration, no, always part ng agenda is itong investors na gumandang ekonomiya natin. No? So, bakit naman hindi pagbigyan na gumanda yung ekonomiya natin? Wala naman nakalagay doon na sa ano na walang eleksyon. Andiyan pa rin ang right ng tao na pumili ng kung ma-approve tong economic amendment, wala naman sinasabi, tinanggalan ng right yung tao. Kung hindi niyo magustuhan, next year eleksyon na, di wag niyo iboto. Diba? Para palitan kung hindi magustuhan ng mga tao. That will be the time na majority of the people will choose kung maganda ba yung ginawang amendment o hindi. No? Sana naman pagbigyan natin, no? Itong Maharlika Bill na dapat expected from the both houses will support yung programa ng presidente. No? Yan ang nakakano pagka hindi natin nasusuportahan ang programa ng presidente. Very, very timely kasi maaga pa lang, no? 1 year and a half pa lang nakakaraan ng administrasyon ni BBM, no? Sana naman pagbigyan natin. Kung napagbigyan natin yung mga ibang presidente na nakaraan, no? Kanya-kanyang ano lang yan eh, estilo ng pagdadala. Let's give it a try. No? So, yun lang po.
Okay. Kung JJ, you want to say something po?
Thank you. Magandang hapon. I've been a congressman in the 11th, 12th, and 13th Congress. Tapos ngayon, nakabalik ako. Since 11th, 12th, 13th Congress, palagi pa namin usapan yung charter change. Ngayon, nakabalik po ako sa Kongreso. I've been a governor for 3 terms also. Pinag-usapan din yan namin sa Governor's League. And ang importante lang po, yun lang pong economic provisions. Eh, palagi ko lang tayo, pinagyayabang natin 7, GDP growth natin 7% lang. At, however, Southeast Asian countries, double digit. Grabe sila. So, palagi na akin, hirap ang Pilipinas, hirap ang Pilipino. Eh, ito yung pagkakataon na mag-amendahan. Tapos yung trust po, as what Speaker Martin said, pwede naman tayo mag-usap eh. Let's put it black and white. Ano ba talagang gusto? Pag nag-usap na yon, tuloy-tuloy na sana. Sana po matuloy po yon. Kasi kailangan na natin umuswag. Kailangan na natin na maganda ang bukas, lalo na ho sa mga apo namin. Kaya yun ang tinitingnan. Not only today, but for tomorrow, for our country and for our children's children. Thank you po.
Since session is about to begin in 2 minutes, we can only entertain 2 more questions from from Marian Enriquez of TV5 and Joy Cantos of Filipino Star ngayon.
Opo. Yes. Sir, ano lang
just be quick.
Ano lang pong masasabi po ninyo, particularly dito po sa panawagan po ni Davao City Mayor Baste Duterte na magbitiw na po si Pangulong Bongbong Marcos, and one official sinabi po niya dahil hindi nga raw po maayos ni Pangulo yung gusot between Senate and the House.
Siguro ako magsasagot at dalawang mic na ako. First, I think it's totally uncalled for. In the past 2 years, we have seen the performance of President Bongbong Marcos. We have seen how he has managed the economy coming from the pandemic. We have seen how the country has risen from times when we didn't know kung ano ba ang bukas para sa atin. We have seen how he steered reforms in the agriculture sector, in the infrastructure sector, in our economy, in the delivery of social services, and we have seen his commitment to the Filipino people na hindi maaaksaya ang tiwala na ipinagkaloob sa kanya nung siya'y manalo bilang Pangulo. So yung mga nabanggit sa Davao calling for his resignation, I think is totally disrespectful of the man, given the position that he holds. Number two, has no basis whatsoever. Yung sinasabi na wala siyang compassion, yung sinasabi na na wala siyang pag-ibig, tamad, walang basis yon. Kayo na sumusunod sa kanyang araw-araw na trabaho sa media, nakikita niyo po ang dedikasyon ng ating presidente sa kanyang trabaho, na umaga pa lang nag-uumpisa na ang kanyang schedule sa mga pagbisita sa mga lugar, sa mga maraming cabinet hearings, and I only follow him on what I see on media, and there is so much more that happens that is not shown in media. So, like what I said, it's baseless and uncalled for. And it's unfortunate that it had to be mentioned that way. But nevertheless, kami naman, inuulit ko po kanina, ang commitment at saka ang suporta po namin is unequivocal with regards to our President Ferdinand Bongbong Romualdez Marcos.
Any more reaction from House leaders?
Well, I'll just keep this short, no, because we're going to everybody's got has a right to an opinion. Everybody's got a right to express it. I'll just express mine. I disagree. Simple as that.
Ako naman, masasabi ko lang po, you have to respect the office of the president, di ba? Tsaka, nagtataka po kami bakit pinapa-resign si President PBM. Wala po tayong basihan, ano? Napakasipag, kamukha nung nasabi ni Deputy Speaker JJ. So, palagay ko, pag yung panawagan, alam nyo na yung kasunod, di ba? So, salamat po.
Okay, last one question. Just be quick. From Joy of Filipino Star.
Good afternoon po, sir. Sir, you're encouraging investment po, but tirades after tirades po, it's not good for the country. Ano pong nakikita nyo, it would be an unnecessary sir, if we will not act accordingly and in unity. Ano pong nakikita nyo solution to reconcile with the Senate sa mga issue na ito, sir?
Anyone? Kung JJ.
Can we just ask her to please repeat your question? Kasi I didn't get the first part.
Sir, kasi po you're encouraging investment, but yet among our legislators, tirades after tirades, it's too hot as an ember. Ano pong nakikita niyong solution to reconcile with the Senate do sa mga differences niyo with People's Initiative and sa mga Duterte na rin po? Kasi may warning din po si President na it would be a bloody year for the presidency of PBBM.
Yung differences, normal naman yun siguro. Hindi naman nangyayari na walang difference in opinion, no? Yung ating mga senador, yung ating mga kongresista. So I don't think it will really affect, no? Alam naman ng ating administrasyon saan dapat dalhin ang ating ekonomiya, ang ating bansa. So nakatutok naman doon at nakafocus doon. I don't think there will be some hindrances to that. Even if meron tayong ganitong issue sa on the side. Nasa buhay po ang demokrasya sa Pilipinas. Kaya everybody is allowed to say their piece and say whatever opinion they have on certain issues. We may differ in opinions, pero at the end of the day, dapat magrespetuhan lang. Yun lang. Wala namang sigurong ibang makaka-apekto sa takbo ng ating bansa.
Personally naman, not speaking now as a party leader, no, just as a congressman, I think in an ideal world, kung meron mga disagreements na to, that's the reason we have structures and official structures where we can have these debates. Imposible naman na nag-agree ang lahat sa lahat ng bagay. In a perfect world, we would be discussing this in an official setting with an official output. Not on the streets, not through the media. You know, work the way we should be working, officially.
With that, we're ending our press conference. We thank all our House leaders for updating our media friends on crucial issues of the day. Thanks, everyone. Thanks, sir.